it's about 38 degrees out here. I kind of step back and pick me a line out here, guys, as I draw all the way to the hole, just like I would if I was lining up a putt. And then I come around and get my feet parallel to my target line. Now my feet are actually pointing to the left of the hole. My club face and ball are going at the hole, but I'm not going at the hole with my feet. I don't want to have my feet crossing this line. I want it going parallel with that line. And I pick a spot out here in front, piece of grass, something to line up to. Make sure my club's going straight back across the line that I see before and after the ball. Take my club straight back on it. Keep my peripheral vision level until my club goes through it. And check your grip. Let's start all that over again. Let me have the right grip. I'm not going to cut that one out. Get my feet parallel. Stand up and check your grip. I always do that. Except for that last time. Then go straight back, straight up, straight away. Yep. Grip makes a big difference, doesn't it? And guys, that's the reason you have to check this stuff every shot, because believe me, as many balls as I hit, if I can make that mistake, believe me, you can make that mistake. Talk about their hands in front all the time. Okay, if you turned this golf club that far in and set up, your brain would tell you, well, heck, I gotta get my hands in front to square it up, right? That's what they're doing on tour.
Explain it again. They're turning it in. And
they're turning the club in like that. Uh-huh. Actually, they grip it like that, and then they turn over here like this. But they're turning the club in like that, and then they get their hands in front to square it up. Uh-huh. That's all they're doing. That's all they're doing.
Huh. Wow.
Now they can give you all kinds of analysis on what they're doing, but that is what they're doing right there. Now this straight shot that I like to hit more than anything else, I'll admit, when I'm off, it's going away from the target. Versus the pros that like to fade the golf ball so they take it away from the hole and then they let the ball be moving toward the hole. But still, my margin for error left and right from 200 is not as wide as the green. And the closer I get, the more that narrow shrinks down. So I don't worry about if it's going not dead straight, if I hit this shot, I don't worry about those shots. I just didn't want this. And what I do eliminated that. Here's a little something for you guys. Heavy cock left hand instead of right hand. Take your one piece takeaway. And from right there, cock your left hand. Then finish your swing. That's where you should be. That's different. And taking your one piece takeaway and cocking your right hand. Big difference. Take your one piece takeaway, cock your left hand. So if you're backswing, go with it. Guys, I come out here in all kinds of weather. It's very cold out here tonight. I got the heaters on. But I do it just to keep the feel of the weight of the club in my hand. Ball's not going to go as far as it does when it's 90 degrees. I don't care. I take one more club. I swing slow. Maintain my rhythm. Here's a good test for y'all to keep you from pulling back with your right hand. Practice that one piece takeaway, guys. And when you get to that spot over here, cock left hand. Not right. See the difference? Right back and then cock left hand and then finish your golf swing, your back swing. That'll put you in the position you need to be in. The more important than taking a great big back swing is being able to release it as full as you want to at the bottom for the crispness. And you don't have to swing real far back to do that. You just have to be in balance and everything in line. So I stop right there, and then from there I just fire everything at it. My biggest problem is not my swing anymore, it's alignment. Get in the hole. Well, that's close. Golfers, you need to be a parallel railroad tracks, I call it. Need to be parallel. Take the club straight back. Cock left hand. Finish your back swing. There's a reason for this, guys. There's a reason for it. If you do what I'm asking you to do, take your time and do it exactly, this is how you're going to hit a golf ball the rest of your life. I guarantee it.